One editing technique that has surged with landscape photographers is the Orten effect. It's hard to miss when you scroll through Instagram. Sometimes it's overdone, but when it's applied right, it gives a creative, soft, dreamy feel to your photo. A lot of people assume that the Orten effect can only be applied in Photoshop, because most of the time you only want to apply it to the highlights of your image. But the good news is you can achieve the same results in Lightroom in a matter of steps. In this video, I'm going to show you a straightforward 5-step process into how to achieve this effect without using Photoshop. This is an image I captured during my recent trip to the Dolomites. I'm really happy with how the effect turned out, but I'd like to enhance the light and add the Orten effect to the highlight areas of the image. The first step is to create a total mask to this image, which means we have to cover the whole image in a mask. Now, we could do this a few different ways, but today I'm going to show you how to not do it and how to do it. Now, we could use the gradient mask, which is going to mask out the whole of the image, but it's going to be somewhat strong at the top or the bottom, however you put the gradient around. It's going to be somewhat strong on one side and then weaker on the other side. That's not really going to work for us. We need it strong on the highlight part of the image. So this is what you want to do. A far better approach is to use the brush tool. So let's delete the gradient mask and start fresh. I'll open the mask panel and select the brush. Make sure to set the brush size to 100%. Lower the feather to 0 and crank the flow and density up to 100%. Now, with a few broad swipes over the entire image, we now have a complete mask covering the whole of the image. This is a crucial step because you want the Orten effect to really be over the whole of the image, especially the lighter areas. Now, let's move on to step 2. We want to add the signature glow that the Orten effect is known for. This part is pretty simple, but yet it's essential. First, we want to increase the exposure slightly to 0.2 or 0.15. Somewhere around there should work. Now we're going to bump up the contrast to around 20. You really don't want to go too high with the contrast because that's just going to diminish the glow that you're going for, but somewhere between 20 and 10 is really perfect. Next, we're going to reduce the highlights to about negative 25. The reason for this is we don't want the highlights to blow out the entirety of the image. We want them to glow. We don't want them to blow out and be clipping in our whites. So we'll reduce that to about negative 25. By balancing these adjustments, we've now created a subtle brightness that doesn't overwhelm the image. So if we toggle this on and off, we can have a look. Now you can notice that soft, gentle glow starting to appear across the whole of the image. Now we're ready for step 3, where we're going to focus on softening the whole of the image. The Orten effect is famous for combining the glow and the softness to an image to give it a real dreamy, atmospheric type look, which is what it's really known for. Now to achieve this, we'll go to the effects panel and lower the clarity to about negative 25. This reduces the mid-tone contrast, making the details appear softer and somewhat more subtle. Then I like to bring up the texture to about plus 10 to retain some of the details in the finer parts of the image. This really adds to that atmospheric haze that the Orten effect is known for. And if we toggle this on and off, you can really see that the Orten effect is starting to take shape. Once we have that soft glow and that atmospheric feel, we move to step 4. So in step 4, we really want to make sure that the Orten effect is only going to affect the brighter parts of the image. But how do we do this? Well, let's go through it. Go to the mask panel and click the 3 dots and select intersect mask with luminance range. This allows us to control where we want the mask to be applied in regards to the luminance values. By dragging the slider, you can exclude the darker images from the effect while keeping it focused on the highlights. To help visualize this, turn on the luminance map where you'll see the areas in black are now excluded from the effect. Pull the slider until only the brighter parts of the image remain highlighted. Now, if we toggle on this mask on and off, now you'll notice the Orten effect is only applied to the brighter part of the images. And that's what we're really going for, to leave those shadows untouched. One of my favorite updates inside of Lightroom was when they brought in the opacity slider. This was a massive boost. This slider allows us to fine tune the overall intensity of the Orten effect. So if you've done it maybe too bright, you can just slide this slider to the left and it's going to reduce that effect ever so slightly. Or if you want it stronger, pump it up all the way to plus 200%. And that's really going to make it bang. But maybe you only want it subtle, slide it back a little bit. Finally, in step 5, we want to sort of bring back the sharpness that we lost. We added this dreamy feel, reduced that clarity, and now we want to bring it back ever so slightly in some of the finer details in the image. Head down to this detail panel and crank up the sharpening to like plus 100. I know that's a lot, but bear with me. Increase the detail to around about 75 and then hold the option key and you use the masking slider to ensure that the sharpening effect only selects the most defined edges. Now, normally I do this on every image anyway, but in this, it's really crucial. This way we restore the crispiness we lost in some of those crucial areas. areas. Now, if you zoom into the image and you turn the sharpening on and off, you can really see how much difference it really makes. Now, if you press F, that'll enlarge the image to the entirety of your screen, and that really gives us a view of how we've transformed this image. The combination of the soft glow, the selective sharpening, you can really tell that the Orten effect has been applied to this image, and it looks sensational. So let's just go back into the normal screen and we'll compare the overall image to how it was before without the Orten effect. You can see how this effect subtly enhances the mood, adding a mystical atmospheric touch without overpowering the whole of the image. Now, I don't use the Orten effect all the time. Specifically, I like to do it in like golden hour if the sun hasn't set, or maybe just before golden hour when the sun is coming down and it's really illuminating the parts of the image that I want it to, then I'll use the Orten effect. If you did enjoy this video, please give a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and we'll see you next week.